this next presentation deals with extracting your source data and preparing it for import into the IBT. So our challenge is that all of the data goes into the system for record keeping, and now you want to share it. So how do you take it back out of your system and prepare it for publishing? We know from the IBT that the data sources that can generate a Durham Core archive from within IPT are CSV and tab and files using any other delimiter. They can be directly uploaded as a CSV, or if they are over 20 megabytes or 25 megabytes, then they need to be zipped or compressed using a .zip or a .gzip file. The other day when we were talking about data content considerations, most of you indicated that you have Microsoft Excel and that's what you use for your data source. So I'm going to demonstrate Excel and Microsoft Access. So Excel is pretty simple. You go up to your file menu, click on Save As, change your file type to comma separated values, and give it an appropriate name, and then you hit Save. Now we talked a lot about if your data had any diacriticals in it, or you might need encodings, things like that. With Excel, you can't control that. So if you want to specify that your data is in UTF-8, you need to, once you've saved it in Excel, bring it into one of the other systems we looked at, perhaps Notepad++, and you can change it to UTF-8 there. The way Excel exports to the CSV file, if you take that directly to IBT and upload it, it recognizes if it was one of the standard encodings, like on my machine, for example, it was Mac Roman, it recognizes that within the IPT. So when we get to the next session where we upload it into IPT, I'll point those things out. Access is a little more complicated. There are several more steps, but you have a little bit more control over what you export. So the first step is you open your Access database and you find the table or the query that you want to export. You right-click it and click on the export. You can also do the same thing from file, the file menu. The next screen, it asks you to locate it in your file directory and give it a file name to save it. And then you click the export button. That begins a wizard within Access. And these screens will look slightly different depending on the version of Access you use, but they're mostly the same in terms of the functions available. So right away we choose delimited because we know we have commas as delimiters and that our characters are separated by quotes when it's a text field. I think we captured in the screenshot that there's a next button down there. When you click next, the second screen of the wizard allows you to separate again that you can choose your delimiter. So if you wanted to switch it to something else, like a tab, a semicolon, a space, you could. For this exercise, I'm leaving it as comma. We do want to include the field names on the first row, and our text qualifier is the quote. Along the bottom of the screen that it's not showing, there are several buttons. There is an advanced button, a back button, and the next button, and a finish button. To bring up this next screen, I click the advanced button, because I want to be able to go in and tell it that I want to encode the data as UTF-8, and I want information about my dates. I want to tell it that I want the date order to be year, month, day. I want the date delimiter to be a dash, so I want my dates separated by dashes. I want it to express the year in four digits, and I want my months and my days to have leading zeros. I'm also going to export my date as a text field instead of a date field so that I don't get hung up on any of Access's predetermined date formatting. And then at the top of the screen is an OK button, which then brings you back to the previous screen you were on, where you can click Next, which brings you to the final screen, which allows you to finish. At that point, the file exports. So most systems are similar in this manner. If you've got another database system, I know one person mentioned to me that they do have some specified databases. If they're specified 5, it's much more difficult to export the data. Specify 6 has some functionality for that built in. So if anybody's interested in seeing that, I can show you that tomorrow. It's a little bit more complicated to do. And if John showed you this morning with Google Refine how you could export, so if you take your data out of your system, write it into Refine to do some cleanup, and then you want to export it for your Dharma Core archive, you can choose that export button and choose CSV from there.